guys, this is Tara with Kittens, Weights, and Tarot, and today I'm doing a VR to Valamano, and this particular tag is in French, but my homegirl out in Belgium, my bestie out in Belgium, translated it for me so that I could do it in English. The name of the tag is the Esoteric Chinese Portrait, but on Valamano's channel it's Portrait Chinois Esoterique. Esoteric Chinese Portrait. Okay, so there are 12 questions, and it says, if I were blank, you know, what would I be? And so those questions are, if I were a mythical animal, if I were a flower or plant, a color, a deity, a psychic ability, a ritual object, a jewel, a myth, a time period, a number, a month, and an element. So this is just going to be something quick and fun. So here we go. So if I were a mythical creature, I would be Pegasus. I think, number one, I've always had a huge, deep connection with horses ever since I was really young. I even had all these magazines, Equus magazine, that I used to get from my fourth grade teacher. He was a subscriber to that magazine, so I would get all his magazines and I would just like look up on how to care for horses and all of this. So I have this connection to horses. And if I could have an ability, I'd want to be able to fly. So how cool would it be to be like a flying horse? So I would definitely want to be a Pegasus. Number two, if I could be a flower or plant. So right away, I was going to say I would want to be a rose, since I work with roses quite a bit. But I'm very much about summer and sunshine and the sun. So I was like, sunflower. I would want to be a sunflower. I would always want my face directed towards the sun, and I would just soak up all that sunlight, kind of like I do now. Like, I always think that I'm like, if I just had a nice little rock, I'd be like a lizard and I would just like lay on the rock and just like soak up all that sun. But yeah, if I was a flower, I would be a sunflower. If I were a color, the color I would be is glacier blue. I just refer to it as pretty blue, but yeah, that's one of my favorite colors, which is why one of my favorite stones is hemimorphite. I think it kind of looks like that glacier blue. I don't know, just something about that color just looks so clean and pure and cool. And, you know, I'd want to be glacier blue. If I could be a deity, the deity I would be is Green Tara, so the goddess Green Tara. I know that she comes in a variety of colors, and each color is representative of a different thing. But when she is in her green format, she is of healing, and she is connected to the earth, and she is of just compassion and love. And I would love to be the goddess Green Tara. And well, I'm wearing green today, so I'm kind of Green Tara, but not the goddess. All right, if I were a psychic ability, I would want to be psychokinesis, because, you know, how cool would it be to help somebody levitate objects, move objects? Like, I've always thought that that would be such a cool ability, you know, where my alarm goes off and I just like look at the clock and just like, shh, shh, it like silences. Or I'm like, I want something out of the fridge, just like, you know, coconut milk, come to me, you know? You know, so I don't know. I think that would be cool to help somebody. If I were like that psychic ability, I could like help them move stuff, you know, freak people out. If I were a ritual object, I would love to be a wand, because I think that being a conduit of energy would feel pretty freaking awesome. Like, I could help somebody direct energy and to just like feel that energy just pumping through you. I kind of think we're already conduits of energy, so we're kind of already a magical wand in ourselves. But yeah, well, then I could like be really cool and carved, and like if there was like a rose magic wand, like that would be really cool. If I were a jewel, I'm gonna take that as like a stone or a crystal as well. I would love to be hemimorphite. I already mentioned that I love glacier blue. I would love to be hemimorphite. Hemimorphite can come in a few different forms. Sometimes people see it in that kind of like almost like crystalline structure, you know, and sometimes it's in that botryoidal structure. It's, it kind of looks like bubbles. And yeah, you know, so how cool would it be to be something that is still the same thing but can look vastly different, you know, which is interesting of hemimorphite. Plus, it's all about communication. It's kind of, you know, heart, throat chakra here. So yeah, and I'm all about communication. So I would love to be hemimorphite. If I were a myth, I would love to be the Chinese zodiac myth, the great race, you know, how the 12 animals were chosen, or how the first 12 animals crossed the finish line, you know, in the Jade Emperor's great race that he threw to figure out who are, or what would our 12 zodiac animals be. So I don't know, if I were a myth, I think that would be a cool myth to be. A time period. If I were a time period, I would be the 1940s. I know that there was a war during the 1940s, but I also think that after the war, there was a lot of good things that came about because of it. You know, we had women in the workforce, and all of a sudden it was like women were seen a lot differently, you know, kind of after that. It was a catalyst for future things. I think that just ideas and ways of being and doing, you know, everything was in change, you know. And also me being, you know, I wanted to be a fashion designer when I first went into college. I love the fashion and the hairstyles of the 1940s. And I do know that some of that was kind of related to what was going on politically at the time. But yeah, I think... this is a great time of change. It was a good catalyst for a lot of future things, you know, something from something horrible stems something awesome. So I would be the 1940s. If I were a number, I'd be the number 4. I don't know why, I just have always loved the number 4. I've always been 4th in everything. Like, not in my races, I was always first place, but like, when I was in school, like elementary school, I was always number like 4 on the roster. Or we had like a dental unit. Like, I remember when I was in 3rd grade, and I was toothbrush number 4. Like, when we had to line up at recess, I was always like had to be number 4. Like, I was always number 4, and 4 has always been my lucky number. So I don't know, I'll be number 4. If I were a month, I would be June. June is my birth month, but I just like June. I know that here in San Diego we get June gloom, but there have been some sunny days in June, and it's also like the start of summer, which is my favorite season. So yes, I would be June. And lastly, if I were an element, I would be air. Okay, there's a lot of air in my natal chart. I know I'm an air sign, I'm a Gemini, and air is communication and, all of that. And I was like, you know, that's me. I mean, I was like, yes, I connect with all the other elements as well, but air. And as I say this, there is a gigantic raven just kind of like, whoo, outside the window. So yes, I would be air, just to kind of, you know, and I would love to fly. That would be just so cool if I just had the ability to fly. You know, I love air. Hello, Raven. So anyway, that was it. It was just a quick little video. So that VR by Valamano. And yeah, so thank you, Steph, for translating it for me so that I could jump in on this tag too. And I hope that you guys jump on this as well, because this was a lot of fun. So anyway, if you guys dug this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, don't forget to click subscribe, and don't forget to click that ding 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 notification bell for more videos just like this. And if you want to catch a reading from me, head over to www.kittensweightsandtarot.com, where I have not only a plethora of readings, but I have room and body sprays, I have my salves, I have my bracelets that I make, I have my Wally's World Oracle, which was community created and community funded. I also have signups for my newsletter. It's a once a month newsletter, and that's the only time I fill your inboxes once a month with one newsletter, which has fun DIYs, crafty DIYs, witchy spell DIYs, crystals I'm using for the month, teas that I'm drinking, herbs that I'm using, you know, things like that. So definitely check that out. And if you want to throw a little good vibes my way, think about joining that KWT tribe over at patreon.com/kittensweightsandtarot. And I thank you guys for watching, and I will catch you spiritual homies later. Peace, love, and chicken grease. Peace out.